Project management is the application of skills, tools, and methods that reach a certain achievement through the completion of multiple steps. A project is usually a long-term goal composed of several smaller tasks, and as such, the amount of moving parts will usually render the standard to-do lists useless right at the start of your project. For successful and stress-free project management, you should rely on a system that is a little bit more robust and allows you to input valuable information and data while maintaining a structured and reliable system. Whether you are starting a new project, in the middle of one, or collaborating with multiple people, I'm sure these tips will help you, and if some of them are already familiar to you, this should serve as a way to check if you're being as efficient as possible with your projects. I've been using Notion for more than 1 year to basically organize every project in my life, so I'm happy to say that they're sponsoring today's video, but more about that later. An effective project management system should be able to clearly define the goals and objectives of your project, define tasks, manage a timeline, and be adjustable. You should be defining your project goals in a smart way. In other words, they need to be specific, measurable, assignable, relevant, and timely, and you should be clearly able to identify deliverables, costs, timeframes, resources, and stakeholders. The project management software you use should be able to incorporate this easily, and that information should be accessible at all times. You don't have to use anything fancy. You might just find that a simple to-do list will do the trick for you in this case. Setting your expectations in the early stages of the project is essential. You should know with a certain level of detail what are your expectations for the project at hand, including some essential elements of it, including the quality of work, the different assignments that need to be completed in a specific time frame, and the type of tools and data everyone will have to deal with. When managing your project, it's important to make sure that you're preparing the environment well, for instance, the collaborative software you used to work, and also in a very productive way that allows it to be packed with information and tools that will make sure the work actually gets done. You'll then have to clearly define the tasks required to complete the project. These should be broken down as much as possible, and at an early stage should include detailed information about your completion. Using a table that allows you to track progress on your tasks, as well as including valuable details, prices, dates, and other information, is a good way to keep track of individual tasks during a long-term period. Managing a timeline effectively will assign those tasks to specific deadlines, and that's a good way to improve accountability and have a good glance of everything. It's also important to set up your tool so that your timeline is adjustable, so you can then take into account any unforeseen problems that may arise. The important thing here is to take note of those adjustments so that any changes in your original plan can be saved. This makes sure that you create accountability while also keeping an organized record of major decisions during the project. Adjusting your project during its progress is also important because you can't predict everything. Being prepared to shift things around and knowing what to shift is important to guarantee that, despite any setbacks, you're able to make your work more flexible. Delegating tasks to your team in a clear way is a big part of this intelligent management, and providing the right organization tools will make sure that shifting between tasks or smaller sub-projects isn't hard, because all the data is listed and provided accordingly. It's also important to review your work periodically. Performing an exhaustive review of the project will help you tackle problems early on, instead of having to deal with those same problems near a deadline. Reviewing your work is done easily when data is easily shareable, so it's important to enter a mindset where you're constantly reminded that when you're doing something on the long run, you should help yourself in the future too. So adding files, notes, and linking tasks is important so that everything is associated in a specific and foolproof way. It's also a good idea to create a dashboard that is able to compile the most relevant data points, such as your timeline, the task status, the project calendar, completion rate, etc. So, to wrap this up, you should be able to define your goals and objectives in a smart way, as well as your expectations regarding the project. Then it's time to define specific tasks to a timeline that should be organized in a detailed way that allows everyone to easily access the same information. Then your project should be constantly adjusted and reviewed so you'll be able to reach the completion point without stumbling too much. All of your project management can be achieved with Notion. Notion is a great tool both for your own individual projects as well as your whole team, or if you have people collaborating with you in a more informal way. Having powerful software that makes sure you're all on the same page is even more important now that everyone's working from home while staying connected. With Notion, your team will be able to create wikis that keep everyone informed, manage projects all in one spot, share documents so that they're easy to find and edit, and much more. Also, Notion is fully customizable, so you'll never be stuck to one template. I used to collaborate with multiple people for my YouTube channel, and I've created lots of projects in it, from writing an ebook to planning for a wedding to designing my website. But if you think you want to use something more classic, you can use one of the tons of templates they provide for Teams, which you can also modify freely. And speaking of free, you can try and explore Notion anytime you want for free and for as long as you like before you upgrade to the Teams plan. If you want to start using this awesome tool, you can sign up for free using this link, which will also be provided in the description box below. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you next week. Bye guys!